calmly on the water. Close-up views of the Needles, rocks and lighthouse.
The annual inspection takes about an hour and a half, once every 3 years, and it's always during the summertime when it's nice and calm.
So they come up here in good weather.
That's right.
All the windows are open.
Yep.
And it smells nice.
Blue skies, fluffy clouds.
They think it's like there all the time.
Yeah. During the winter, there's water dripping down the walls. All the silverfish are doing the backstroke in the bunk.
We actually have three keepers out here on the lighthouse at all times. These chaps do a shift out here 4 weeks on, and then they get 4 weeks off duty. The bad news is we are in fact going to lose the keepers, certainly within the next 18 months. We're going over to a fully automatic operation. Everything's round on the lighthouse. Keepers all sleep together in a big round bed.
I want to marry a lighthouse keeper and live by the side of the sea. I'll polish his lamp by the light of day so that night can find their way.
Trinity House are cutting down on keepers, and we feel that the eyeball is missing from the coast. When you consider that here there are four keepers and their families, it's a busy part of the coast for small boats. You're taking eight sets, possibly, of eyes off the lookout on the coast. I think there's danger in that.
We find that having a lighthouse manned makes all the difference to seafarers feeling as they pass at sea, and also that things go wrong, we found, when they come automatic. And on Lunday, where I've been looking after lighthouse keepers there for the last 10 years, Lunday South and Lunday North, now Lunday North is automatic, and Lunday South, every other day it seems to have to go to back to London North to put things right, you know, but a seagull goes past and the foghorn goes on or something, you know. Lighthouse keepers can be relied upon to take action when necessary.
Needles Lighthouse, one of the last three of the offshore lighthouses run by Trinity House. Even the Bishop Rock Lighthouse off the Scilly Isles has gone automatic now. It's the end of an era. I've been on board these places for 19 years and spent half my life on there. It's a way of life that is going. In 2-3 years' time, it'll be gone for good. And this is why I would like the film made now. Don't forget what I said. Any trouble, don't hesitate to give me a ring. Those 28 days of onboard duty start about 3 or 4 days before we go out. We have to organise our provisions, we have to tie up all loose ends at home, have to pay bills, and we generally have to get all loose ends squared away and then we come down to the Isle of Wight from all over the country, and then come out onto the lighthouse. And once we're out on the lighthouse, then that's when our 28 days of duty actually begin.
Only a little bit more to go.
That's about it, isn't it?
Yeah.
Another 28 days worth of grub.
That's right.
See you in a month's time,
yeah,
mate.
Yeah, see you later, Tony.
All right, Kenneth.
Hello, Joe. All right?
You got all my stuff there?
Yep.
Yeah, not so bad. As I say, I don't think I'm going to have an awful lot of room here.
It's usually on about the Monday or the Tuesday of the week that Tony goes back. That I start in all the boxes come out, the red boxes and the bags, all ready to be packed with all his belongings, and the sight of those just makes me feel really miserable. So I'm thinking that's it for 28 days. I'm never going to see him for 28 days. It's a much more lonelier life for the wife. Tony's got two other chaps around him all the time. I'm stuck in a flat on my own, whereas Navy wives have got clubs and they've got someone next door who's in the same situation as they are. But I'm on my own essentially while Tony's away.
It looks very good for tomorrow, Ali. Just a small low coming across. But that should be okay.
It's very important to make sure that the forecast is available to yourself, because on our lighthouse, we're the last lighthouse in the whole country that does the relief by boat.
Yeah, it looks absolutely fine. No trouble. You won't get wet.
Should we come out here, drop us anything, freezing cold in this blooming weather. It's soaked, skin, everything's wet, so you're all right.
Well, everybody seems to think a lot on safety lines now, don't they? And yet they go and cut down a 24-hour watch from the Coast Guard station, and then the Trinity House go and cut down the 24-hour watch from the lighthouse. So, in fact, virtually you've got no lookout at all on this western headland. I mean, if you sink between 10:30 and 4 o'clock on a weekend, that's fine, somebody will see you. But outside of those hours, there'll be nothing. The safety services now rely on other boatmen in the area to do their job for them. That's virtually what happens. I mean, I got into trouble down there a couple of days ago by a little dinghy broken down. Two people in an undersized dinghy, engine broken down, two fellas trying to paddle against the tide, not a hope in hell. I went in to try and pick them up and clipped the bloody prop on the rock. See? I always rely on other people to get them out of trouble.
What have you done? What have you done to the weather? What a day.
Where have you been?
3 hours early.
And that's going to fit up.
That picture there, he's really looking like Thea. I think it's the eyes. He's got two of them.
Well, people say he does look...
Some people have asked me, is it a lonely life? Depends what you mean by lonely. If you mean that you're all on your own out here, certainly not. We have a good crew out here. We all get on very, very well, laughing and joking. We don't have to pass the time by. Time actually passes us by.
When I go on the relief out on the boat and leave Tony there, I always take a last look back at the lighthouse just before we round one of the bays, before it disappears. And that is my last sort of link with Tony for the next 28 days. And it makes me feel very sad, because I know that he's not from home. He's about 15 miles away. I just can't get to him. It's impossible to reach him apart from by phone. So there's no contact at all for 28 days.
my bunk. It's curved, as is all the bunks on a Tower Rock lighthouse, because it has to go around the curvature of the wall. I use a duvet cover now because I got sick and tired of having to put sheets, square sheets, on a curved bunk. Plus the fact I'm nearly 8 foot up on a ladder, it makes life a little bit difficult.
We have all our services on station. There's nothing coming from land. Our water and the coal and the fuel all has to be supplied by ship, which is supplied downstairs.
You can't have a shower every day because of the water. We only carry 12,000 litres of water in a storage tank underneath the engine room, and you have to be reasonably frugal with it, so we generally have a shower every third day. This tower is very, very fortunate in as much as it's got a proper flush toilet where we pump the water from the sea, so there's an unlimited supply of water for that. Personal hygiene in a place like this is a must. You've got to keep yourself clean, and to get on with each other, you've got to grin and bear each other's little foibles, idiosyncrasies and what have you. We've all got them, but you try not to make a big issue out of it.
If you allow a small thing like smoking or sweaty socks or whatever it is, or people's attitudes, it can be blown out of proportion. Mm. But again, it's down to the individual to control it.
The majority of people did smoke. I usually tailor-made, and in a small kitchen like this, it not only made a terrible smell, but they used to literally stain the paintwork.
All we can say now to the smokers is, don't.
Yeah. Well, it's not that intrusive. I mean, it's... it's only me, and I don't smoke it all the time,
no,
you know.
Sure.
Have a couple of little puffs and put it down.
Don't have a go at me, I'm only the boy.
Well, this is it, yeah, I'm only the boy. Once again, as you say, it's a struggle for power. They're not prepared to share it.
In America, their service is run by the Coast Guard. A totally different outlook. Although they are really a model of how we should really be going, I believe, under one blanket organisation. The only people that really want to feel that they're losing out is a small boat owner who just use coastal waters for leisure activities. But they don't contribute anything towards the upkeep of lighthouses. Not a penny. But from our point of view, seeing so many boats around this part of the country, just a £5 or £10 tax on each boat every year, like a road fund licence, that would pay for an awful lot, a tremendous income. And I don't think many boat owners would be reluctant to pay that amount.
How many times have we seen them coming past here? It's crass incompetence and stupidity. Mm. They've got the brains enough to make the money to buy the damn yacht in the first place, and then they leave their brain cell ashore when they take it out. Right, so some sort of driving test, if you like, and some sort of licence fee. To sweeten
the rather bitter pill of a licence fee, you could say that a proportion of that licence fee would go directly, no strings attached, to organisations like the RNLI and the Inshore Rescues. I don't think anybody could have any... The number of times over the years that a keeper has spotted a red flare just when he's been casually looking out of the window, I wouldn't like to put a number on how many lives have been saved. There was an occasion where a coaster hit the shingles bank to the north of us, but the keepers aboard the lighthouse, they spotted this incident happening.
I mean, we can help people in trouble. So if somebody came up on the rocks here, we could actually bring them in here, get them warm, get them fed, and get some help. But if we're knocked here, there's nothing. If there's a distress in the area, we're the first people they phone up. And sometimes we even have to guide a lifeboat, because we are the only eyes on the end here.
Well, we had 6¾ hours of fog today. It gets up to the 40 or 50 hours non-stop that you start thinking about taking the Valium. Oh. Just wait for the Coast Guards to phone up for the weather at midnight. And then I can call out my opposite number, Jerry, make him a cup of tea, and then most gladly turn into bed. Good morning, Needles Lighthouse. Good morning, Skipper. Yeah, certainly. Right, we've got a north-west force 3 with a slight sea, and we have excellent viz at more than 15 miles. Okay, cheers for me. I'll talk to you at 4. Good night. No, it's not a normal life as a lighthouse keeper. It's almost like going into a monastery, if you like, but it's not. I mean, you are voluntarily isolating yourself away from your friends and family for the sake of, at the end of the month, a paycheck. But having said that, after you've done the job a few years, without a doubt, it becomes a part of you, and you become a part of it. That's not getting romantic about it, it's a fact of life. When you come out here for 28 days at a time, you've got to be like a bit of a Jekyll and Hyde. You've come away from all the hurly-burly of civilization, traffic and all sorts of things that you take for granted, living in that environment all the time. Then all of a sudden I come to a dead halt for 28 days where time just goes so slowly. And it does take a while to adjust. The modernization program is inevitable. And when the day comes that places like St. Catherine's or whatever goes automatic, the keepers who are there now are not only out of a job, they're out of a home, they become homeless. So now, everybody who's in a tied cottage, if you like, a Trinity House dwelling, has got to be actively seeking alternative accommodation, either buying their own place or having their names put on the local housing authority list. So it's become that important. It's not just the job that a keeper's going to lose, it's his lifestyle. And after some people 30, maybe 40 years, that's a hell of a lot to give up.
Routine actually covers the maintenance of the building each day, that is the cleanliness of the building. So the chap was on morning watch, that is from 4 a.m. We'll start at about 5 o'clock at the top and work his way to the bottom, just keeping the place clean. So the whole job is done every day.
The first saw the pictures that he
We've got north, west, 4-3, slight sea, visibility is excellent at 15 miles. Okay, not a job. Bye-bye. It's given me a living. It's given me a career. It's been good. I don't think I would have changed it. I wouldn't do it again, but I don't think I'd have changed what I've done. Well, I've been 26 years with the lighthouses. I was 6 years at sea before that, so I turned out 30 years plus in a marine environment. I live in the middle of Lancashire. What am I going to do? It's going to be a big struggle, of course it is. I'll certainly miss it. Just the environment, because I'm going from a seaside environment, a marine environment, to a town, an industrial town environment. Tremendous upheaval, I think. It's going to take a lot of adjustment.
Morning, Gordon.
Morning, Charlie. Sleep well?
Yeah, not so bad.
I've been in this job nearly 20 years, and I think to myself, of those 20 years, I've probably wasted half of that time stuck out here on granite tubes, halfway out in the middle of the English Channel on some occasions, and in a few years' time, I'm going to be made redundant. It all seems so pointless now. After all that's gone into it, not just from me, but from all lighthouse keepers, it seems rather an ignominious end.
You haven't done an awful lot with your life, have you, Gordon?
not a lot. Made a living.
No, I would say last night. Gosh, I thought last night, you know, thinking about Alison and the baby, thinking about almost 20 years of this job, spent 10 years of it on a granite tube. No, I'm not going to. Even if the job was open, I think I would take a long, cold, hard look at the future.
So if you want to make your dreams come true, be a lighthouse keeper, do. We could live in a lighthouse, white one by the bay. Won't that be okay?
There's a lighthouse, shines across the bay.
There's no way that the elder brethren can possibly be really in touch with the shop floor.
Hey, Alex, is newspapers from Ian?
They now have a triannual inspection. Inevitably, they come down June, July and August time. They see the lighthouse on a beautiful sunny day. No idea really of how the place works through a 12-month period. And especially during the winter time when you're closed up inside here, sometimes fortnight, 3 weeks, and you can't get outside at all.
Counting the day.
Especially if we should have a short service before paying off, as it were.
This is the 156th year that the lighthouse has had duty watchmen as a manned lighthouse with lighthouse keepers here. And unfortunately, as you realise, it's going to be the last year that there are going to be duty keepers.
Let it shine, let it shine, let it shine.
And I was disappointed to feel that there'd be no one down here to protect the shipping which we love to see going by these coasts. Not for now, but for all the shipping that's going to be coming by in the future as well. Well, Trinity House has decided to do this, but I hope Trinity House will also ensure that there is somebody down here who will continue to look after our shipping around our coast.
the southern approach, say, for instance, on the Wolf Rock, as was, and you're in a small kitchen like this, you'd have all the windows shuttered up, stop the sea coming in, and whenever a wave hit, it'd make a terrific sort of clang down below, like a metallic noise, and the whole tower would shake. And then as the sea ran up the tower, you get this terrific pressure inside the tower, make your ears pop, and then as the water receded, it would go the other way.
The hurricane struck us about 2:30, and it was green water coming up past all the kitchen windows. Every window was leaking, all the way down from the service room downwards, and I was just doing it just for 4 hours, mopping up. When I called out Ted for watch, what hurricane? Slept through the biggest storm in living history. But what got me annoyed was later on next day, we had a telephone call to ask if we had had any structural damage. And I said, no, everything's all intact. All right, thank you very much indeed, goodbye. I said, oh, sir, just before you go, yes? I said, and all the keepers are okay as well.